Now, I don't know about you, but I use a lot of wax paper and foil. And so I looked at this box and I thought, I'm not going to throw that away. It was in my recycle bin, trust me. So I also took out some of these projects that I've shown you before using the plastic caps. And I thought, why not use the wax paper or the foil box and the plastic caps, the same technique. Let's take a look. For this project, you can use any cardboard box. Cereal boxes are fine. I thought it would be fun to use a wax paper or like a foil box because we don't usually do too much with them. I go through a lot of them. So the first thing you need to do is to glue the flap inside. And I just used some hot glue, put it on the flap, and then pressed it hard until it was set up. So I have my box ready here. I want to cover the end first because I'm using scrapbooking paper and the scrapbooking paper doesn't go completely from end to end. So I know that the box is 2x2 and my ruler is 2x2. I'm using some craft foam here and I'm going to score it with my stylus. Now be sure you check with your paper because this paper that I chose, I noticed I can't go very hard or it goes right through the paper and it has like a white, you know, the white inside the paper. So make sure you just choose your paper or just don't score so hard. Now I'm going to cut in the flap. And this is what we're making for the end of the box, to cover the end of the box. Now if you wanted to, you could paint the box too. You don't have to put the paper, you can just paint the box. And just use a sponge to paint it, you get a little bit better of a look. Now today I'm using the Aline's Tacky Tape Runner. I like this because it's quick and easy. It gives me an instant hold with the self-adhesive tape. Just go around all your edges. And I want a little bit that's going to go on the top. You line that up on the top of your box. Put the sides down that have the flaps first. And then your other side. Now, if my box isn't exactly even, you will get this, so just trim it. Now, for the main part of the box, again, it's a 2-inch box, so I've scored 2 inches, 2 inches, 2 inches, 2 inches, 4 times, and then I have a 1/2-inch flap. So we're going to fold that. And there's my flap. Again, using your Aline's Tacky Tape Runner. I'm going to go along the edge. And I probably need one more piece down here. Line it up. And there you have your covered box. So we'll make this the front of our box with our flap in the back. And then you can take papers And I've just cut some scrapbooking papers that I had. Or anything that you had. I had some of this tissue paper I thought would be pretty on it. And we could put some other ones like here. And then you have your plastic bottle caps. They come in all different colors. So you can keep them the way that they are, or you can paint them. If you're going to glue them on, use the Aline's Tacky Glue. And you can either put them on upside down. And remember, this dries clear. And this one's a little big for there. Let's put another green one here. I wanted to show you that you can also put it upside down like this. Then the fun thing is to pick what you're going to put in it. You can use buttons. Or you can use like the glass marbles, the flat back marbles. And there you have your art piece. Let's take a look at the pieces that I started out with on canvas and board. Okay, this is one that I did on just some masonite board that I had left over. Again, you could just do it on cardboard or the boxes. But it shows how I painted it on. I sponge painted my background, and then I have all the different bottle caps here with some tile, again buttons, and then a glass flat marble. So, and then I just put some dots with some paint. It makes it really cool look for an art piece. And on the back of it, I just glued a hanger. Here's one that I did on a canvas, and again, a pizza box is perfect. And you have to draw the lines that you want that are evenly spaced apart on your box, and then paint each one. And I just randomly painted it. It wasn't anything that was neat or anything. And then all of them are glued, and you can see how every other one is upside down and putting the different things on it. Little tiles, jewels, buttons, the flat back marbles. It makes a perfect art piece.